Hey everyone, how's it going? Today I'm giving my first thoughts on the ZTE Paragon. This is for Net10 Wireless, and I've had this phone for a little bit, and so I'm giving my first thoughts on the phone, give you the specs, and just kind of go around the phone a little bit. So let's go ahead and get started. This phone runs Android 4.4 KitKat. It does have a 4-inch display at 480 by 800 resolution at 233 pixels per inch. This phone does have a 5-megapixel camera on the rear with an LED flash, records in 720p in the rear, max resolution, and has a VGA front-facing camera and VGA video quality. This phone has a 1.2 GHz dual-core Snapdragon 200 processor with an Adreno 302 GPU, with 1 GB of RAM, 4 GB of built-in storage, with around only 1 GB available to user, and it will support up to a 32 GB micro SD card. This phone has a 1650 mAh battery, and I'm uncertain right now of talk and standby time, so we'll get into that in a more full review. This phone is a 4G phone, however, it's not an LTE phone, so it HSPA Plus, so yeah, no LTE, but does have 4G, or beefed up 3G, I guess you would say. This is really a nice little phone. This phone, I got it for very cheap on Black Friday. Actually got it for $4.99. Yeah, for an Android phone, not bad at all. And the phone works pretty well, I gotta say. It is small, and a 4-inch display. But the display looks pretty good. Display don't look washed out, nothing like that. It looks pretty good for what you're paying for the phone. I believe that the price of this phone is originally like $30, something like that. So it's not bad anyway. On the back here is your camera and your flash. Down here is your single rear speaker. On the left side, you got your micro USB charging port. You have your volume rocker here. On top is your headset jack. Power button on the right, and on the front is your ear speaker up top, your front facing camera, and on the bottom, on the body, as you see here, is your back, home, and recents button. They do light up, so they're on the body of the phone, which is also a major plus. The phone is not activated, so you really can't comment on call quality, nothing like that. However, I do believe this phone works on T-Mobile service. And as you know, with carriers like, you know, Net10, Straight Talk, Straight Track Phone, they use different carriers. They use Verizon, they use AT&T, T-Mobile. And this one right here, from when I set it up, it did say something about T-Mobile. So I'm guessing that's who I have service with. And right now, I'm showing no bars of service. And that's just how it is right now with T-Mobile in my area. I got service 1 minute, next minute is out of service. So, yeah. And also up top here beside the camera, you'll see it here in a second. It'll flash again as your notification light. There it is. As like I said, this phone cost me $5 on Black Friday. And I gotta say, if you're wanting a phone that's just small, you know, feels pretty sturdy. It's kind of blocky feeling, you know, of course, you know. Just a cheap, low-end phone. But I gotta say, screen quality for what you're paying for the phone is really not too bad. It's kind of hard to tell here on the front-facing camera here on my Warp Elite, but the screen does not look bad. The screen is pretty responsive. Really don't have any lag to it. Of course, I'm not really, you know, using a whole lot, but right now, as you can see, it's pretty quick, pretty speedy, and I was kind of shocked and surprised on how good the phone actually did work. When I pulled it out of the box, started using it a little bit. The battery is also removable. Let me pull the back of it off here. And as you see, up top here is your micro SD card slot, micro SIM card slot right here, and your battery is replaceable, which is really nice if you, you know, want to buy a spare battery and stuff like that. No NFC, nothing like that, of course, for a phone in this price range. But this phone right here, I would say, is a good phone for somebody who wants to buy one for their kid, who wants a good secondary phone. If you, I did put a T-Mobile SIM card in here, and it did not say anything about it being locked. So Maybe the SIM card is expired. It just won't show any service. I'm not really sure. But I did put the Net10 card in a T-Mobile phone, and it did show service. So it must work. I don't know. Like I said, the T-Mobile phone that I had before, the SIM card did expire. So I may not have any service on it, or I may not show any bars on it. I'm not sure how that works with GSM right now. So yeah. The camera on this phone, you would think it would be pure junk. And in bright light and in dark, like in this kind of light set here, it ain't the greatest. The camera is not great. It does not have autofocus. Nothing like that. What you see, what you get. But if you're in bright light, like you're outside, you're in your car, the camera does take some fairly decent pictures. Video quality is, for 720, you know, on a phone like this, does record pretty well what you can expect on a phone this price range. VGA camera in the front, also 640x480 video recording in the front as well. And I gotta say, I have took some a selfie picture, a self video, and in bright lighting, it does not look half bad, to be honest with you. So, like I say, you know, I'm gonna be doing more of a full review on this phone later on, some benchmark tests, stuff like that, you know. I'll give you more details of the phone. Right now, this is kind of the first look of the ZTE Paragon. Nice little phone. Be a nice phone for a kid. Nice secondary phone, backup phone. You know, you can get for $20-$30. You know, of course, Black Friday had it for $5 a piece at Best Buy. But now, $20-$30 for this phone is not a bad price. And I gotta say, you know, it works well. So anyway, any questions or comments about this phone, leave them in the comment section below. Get back with you as soon as possible. Hit that like button. I'd appreciate that as well. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. I sure would appreciate it. Y'all have a good one. Stay tuned.